Fantanka organization specialized in raising sexual and reproductive health awareness in the Gambia, particularly among young people, on Friday validated a youth SADO report to complement the TRRC final report. The chief executive officer of Fantanka organization, Mariama Jobate, gives details of the SADO report.
In addition to any recommendations that the TRRC's final report has, this report, this shadow report, charges the state, basically the government and other stakeholders to ensure that all reform initiatives are taken into account and address youth needs and capabilities. Therefore, signaling a departure from a historic marginalization and exposing the country's youth to exploitation.
She also explains the objectives of the document.
We want to ensure that the young people's voices are included as much as possible. So we want everybody to come in and help us document their experiences. We also, part of the objective, want to analyze the impact of human rights violations against youth, provide recommendations to address the impacts of violations on youth. We cannot do it on our own. You know, we rely on the victims themselves, the direct and the indirect victims. And I'm sure everybody felt like, you know, a victim during the dictatorship somehow, because the fact that you are denied, you know, to express what you want to say in itself is problematic, you know, denying you the right to talk.
A lawyer and a co-founder of Fantanka, Imran Dabo, explains how Gambian youth were exploited under the Jammeh regime.
Jammeh treated, like I said, youths in the Gambia in the same vein. So politically active youths were induced and exploited. I think we did not, Mariama has not mentioned the green youth, or she just touched on it. But the green boys were this movement that Jammeh and his people created. It was first called the 22nd July movement, named after his coup d'etat. And what they were used for is these politically active young people that he used to orchestrate attacks on his political opponents and things like that. That was in itself also another form of exploitation. And those that he could bring to his corner, he used to commit more human rights violations. Those that challenged his authority or tried to assert their constitutional rights, he crushed. So this is basically how he treated young Gambians. And for young Gambian women who found themselves under the yoke of sex, all of them found themselves under the yoke of sexual and psychological, economic, physical subjugation, which has become a trend now that is continuing and needs to be challenged and stopped.
The lawyer says how youth miss a lot of opportunities during the regime.
The impact of 22 years of dictatorship on Gambian youths, as the presentations I believe have shown, is far-reaching, and it continues because it's not an impact that can be easily changed. The confidence of the youth is affected, their opportunities, because some of them lost opportunities to educate themselves to the level that they would have needed to progress better in life. Their confidence is affected. You know, the role that they could have played in the course of or the progression of the country and their futures has also been affected. So since the change of government, the space has opened for young people to exercise their voices. Yet many youths still believe that even though they are able to speak out, they are still being given a deaf ear.
Fantanka organization also promotes the use of contraceptives for prevention of unplanned pregnancies, STIs, unsafe abortions, and other negative sexual and reproductive health outcomes. Reporting for Kerfatu, I am Bubba Gajigo.